Hey, what's up everybody, my name is Trophinet and welcome back to XCOM 2 and our commander playthrough. Last time we lost one soldier, not because I accidentally blew her up, totally not because I accidentally blew her up, but today we're gonna start off by looking at who the other soldiers in our armory are, because the four guys and of course girl that we went out with weren't the only soldiers that we actually have access to. So let's view our soldiers. So we have Benito, Cedric, and Geralt. That's okay. Oh, look! And I'm actually in this playthrough as well. My character is here as well. So I'm gonna just show you if I can. There we go. So that's my character. Yeah, it looks a bit silly, but you kind of saw that in the recruitment video already. So that's my character. Then we have Vryar. I think he's one of my... I like to think of him as one of my bigger fans. One of my biggest fans. So Ulrich Edel. Vryar's character, so thank you Vryar for submitting your character. Then we have Christoph Vinewood, the runner, and Christoph is of course the other guy you can watch in full glory in our group therapy sessions. So that's that, and then we have, well, my girlfriend's character actually, so Jesse Hyde, also called Joss. There we go. So that's our first few characters. I think I might actually try to recruit someone else. Let's see. We have a few other characters, mostly from the character pool. As you can see, Zoltan Chive from The Witcher. Then we have Yang from Ruby. It's a cool animated series that I watch. Then we have Humongous, another character that was added to the pool by one of my co-workers, I think, yeah. So I think I'm actually gonna recruit Humongous. So that's Donald Trump, by the way. Humongous, there we go. So that's a good start. So now we have 8 active soldiers with 1 in the med bay. And with that done, I think I'm gonna head towards the... I think we do have... Yeah, we have research active, so I'm gonna head to the bridge.
Just stay clear of the perimeter, understood?
Commander.
Because they need us there.
I think we got something here.
Despite all of Advent's efforts, there are still people who refuse to believe their lies. And it's time we let them know they're not alone. We've already located a target for our first operation.
Sir, given our current location, there's actually no way the Sky Ranger could reach that position.
Who said anything about the Sky Ranger? Shen, status report, are we ready?
Short answer, yes. But you might all want to hold on to something.
Because we're no longer in on a stationary base. Because right now, XCOM is aboard not a base, but actually a freaking spaceship. Would you look at that? And that is one hell of an introduction to, yeah, the Avenger. The fucking thing is called the Avenger for some reason. But yeah, that's our new base. So we're gonna be flying around in that.
The Arctic?
Are we seriously starting out in the Arctic? So yeah, the starting position is always random.
Making moves, Commander. By hitting Advent wherever we find them, we can help strengthen the resistance. In return, they'll contribute material and personnel to support our operations.
So when we perform these guerrilla operations, we actually bolster the resistance in that area, and therefore we can get more supplies. And supplies is what we need to buy more stuff. Well, buy more gear, buy more recruits. So there we go, we've acquired a new target for our guerrilla operations against Advent. Let's see, so we have only one in the new Arctic, and we're gonna get an engineer if we are successful. Should be an easy mission, and we need to destroy the alien relay. So let's confirm.
Commander, it looks like Shen prepped a medkit for us. We should equip one of our soldiers with it before they deploy.
And that we will, and since usually you put a medkit on your technician, we're gonna put that in Benito's hands. So let's check his loadout. And swap his grenade out for the medkit. There we go. I think we also have a scope. And of course, the one that will benefit from the scope the most is our sharpshooter. So Cedric will get that scope. Or Oh no, we can't upgrade weapons yet. Okay, yeah, I need modular weapons research first, so we need to finish that research first. So then we have Humongous. It's my co-worker's character, Simon's character, and then my own character. I am wondering... No. So Geralt is still in medbay, so we're gonna have to make do with what we have. So launch! So we're still in the very early stages of the game, so we should be fine on this mission, I hope.
Sky Ranger deployed.
The squad is ready to deploy on your order, Commander.
So, Operation Swampstank, here we go.
A terminal connected to the Advent network through one of their facilities in this area was left exposed by a Resistance hacker during a previous intrusion attempt. We think it may be possible to recover data critical to the aliens' latest operation and stop their progress, but we'll have to move fast. Advent is already working to close the connection. Remove enemy forces from the area, lock it down, and recover that data.
So we need to hack another workstation, pretty much the same way we hacked the power converter in the previous mission. Operation Swampstank in the outskirts of Beijing, apparently. Here we go. Dropping in, nice action poses for all our guys. Our colorful band of soldiers, by the way.
Five, this is Avenger. The access point we're after is just ahead. Move to secure the area. Expect hostile resistance.
So we start out in concealment. We have 8 turns to shut down that network. And well, no time to waste, I would say. So, Cedric, our sniper, I think I'm going to move him up immediately up here to get him a bit of a higher position, because that looks... he can go into the playground over there. So the target is over here in the building. That might be an issue. So I think we're better off trying to start moving to the outsides of this place. Can we actually move through this? No, it's locked off. So let's head to the left here. As long as we don't trigger anything yet, that should be fine, since we're in concealment. So let's move Cedric. I'm gonna move him. Maybe not. I'm gonna have to scout around first.
Choose your route.
So let's put Smongo over there. Benito is good over there. So I think we pretty much have sight lines of everything else. Let's put my character over there. Cedric, move up a bit.
En route vers la position indiquée.
Seems like we only have a few civilians over here. Civilians don't, of course, attack you. But if you move in their sidelines, they will alert any nearby aliens. And thereby breaking your concealment. So let's put them... I don't think they would trigger up there. Maybe they will. That might actually be the case. So let's move you up a bit further.
Oh,
okay, that's quick.
Our gremlins can attempt to access the Advent network from here. We might be able to hack their systems and get an advantage. But be careful. If they detect us, things will only get worse.
So as Shen just explained, the technician, so Benito over here, can hack these towers. And we could get a beneficial effect from that, but also just could. It could also go completely wrong and give the enemy a beneficial effect. Can we actually move through this thing? Yeah, we can. So I think I'm gonna try and put him over here. That shouldn't break concealment, I hope, because otherwise that's gonna hurt. There we go. No trouble. And that's starting to look nicely. I think I have an open sniper shot with Cedric then to start it off with. Which is good, of course. We're all pretty close. Aside from Smongo over here. We could get a little closer, but I'm gonna start off with that sniper shot. So 75% on the trooper, and a lovely 75% on the officer. I wanna kill that guy. And more damage is always handy, so let's try that. Here we go. 75% through the wall, apparently. Ooh, wow, critical. Nicely done, Cedric, in the face. And the trooper is a bit dazed by that. He didn't know what happened. Yep, okay, now he's onto us. Of course he is. Coming closer, you're ballsy on your own. Because I think... let's see. We can get Smongo closer. We do want to have promotions on Smongo and Trophy Nut. So if we can try a few shots with them first... Because I actually have a pretty good position as well. I can actually go to his face. And what about Benito? He can also flank him as well. Not the way I would want this to work out, but... Moving further wouldn't be that big of an issue here. Because we still have a few options. Is it risky? It is risky. I'm gonna try and put Benito closer, hopefully not triggering anything else. Okay, I don't think we did, yeah, okay. So that's 68%, even though they're right across from each other. But first, we have that as a backup now. We know he can't do anything else. We don't trigger anything else, I mean. So that should give us two nice shots, 65%. Trophy Nut first. Dude, that looked ridiculous. So yeah, welcome to XCOM, even those kinds of shots can completely miss. Let's try Smongo's 46%. That was absolutely nothing. Okay, so this could end badly, actually. 68%, please. Oh, 3 damage. Oh, for fuck's sake. So he survived. Yeah, he survived. He survived all that. Wait, what? What the hell did just happen? He didn't move. He didn't do anything. Okay. Well, then. Smongo, I suppose you can move up. There we go, because we do need to get closer to that thing over there. And now we're going to move Benito over here, because this is full cover. I'm just going to assume that we kill the office, the trooper over here. What the hell is going on? Why didn't he do anything? Let's put Trophy Nuts right here then, I suppose. Should give him a flanking shot as well. Now I'm gonna take that. 81%, please hit that. Yeah, thank you. Now you're dealing 5 damage, great. Great, okay. So that was another promotion, that was good. That was really good. I don't wanna get closer just yet. Might want to get a bit closer with Smongo just to get us a bit more of an advantage, because there are windows to this building. And if we spot anything through that, we might as well just keel over and die immediately. I am going to get closer with Cedric as well. There we go.
Location confirmed.
I'm going to have to move towards the door over there if you want to do this, so... I'm not gonna risk it. I really am not gonna risk it with my last. Oh, God. Oh, God. There's a sectoid and a trooper on the roof. Benito with an overwatch shot. And daddy hits. Oh, wow. I have never seen a sectoid do that. That was incredibly creepy. So the trooper went inside through the window. But I think we have pretty nice shots on the sectoid over there. Well done, Benito. Cedric has a sniper shot on the sectoid as well. But I think I'm gonna leave the honors to Smongo over here. Put him right next to the sectoid. Getting us closer to the door as well. And then just 85%. 4 damage. Please, God, do that. Or you're gonna have an alien in your face. Oh, fuck. That was an 85% miss. Okay. I'm gonna have a backup anyway, but... Well, actually, can I use... Oh, hi. I think you're gonna lose your wall over there. I'm sorry, dude. I'm hoping for the 4 damage. That would kill it outright. 3 damage. Okay. But he lost his cover as well, so let's see. Gotta put Benito a bit closer so he can get another flank attempt on the sectoid. The sectoid is a dangerous one over here. So let's try 79 on the trooper and 75 on the sectoid. Well, try the sectoid. The sectoid needs to die. Ooh, that was in the face. That was a headshot. 7 damage. Great work. Great work. That was amazing.
Stop bruciando munizioni.
And then we have full cover with the tree here. And we can use Torilia's pistol to finish this off. 98%. That should not be a problem. It could still miss, but that should not be a problem. Take it in the face. Thank you. Or in the liver, whatever that was. Okay. That was nicely done, guys. Nicely done. That was also our last action, I think. Yeah, there we go. Something exploded. Benito is almost out of ammo, so we're gonna have to be careful around that as well. Let's see. I could send Smongo in already. But we're really close and we still have 4 turns left, so shouldn't be a problem. I'm not gonna... I'm afraid that I'm gonna trigger another batch. I shouldn't, because I think most of the inside of the building is pretty clear, because we can see through the windows and I don't see anything. I'm not gonna send the sniper in first, so let's see. I'm gonna put my character over here next to the window. Don't trigger anything, please.
Eyes on the target.
Okay, so we have eyes on
Commander,
the target, which
we have
is great.
Of the exposed access point.
So let's put our soldiers in better protected positions. We could go inside already, but I'm not gonna do that just yet. I'm gonna do something really weird. I'm gonna open the door even though the wall next to it is completely shattered. Okay, there we go. So now we have sight. Cedric is over here. I don't think this is full cover, although it should be. So I'm just gonna put him over... No, I'm just gonna put him in overwatch. Let's reload you, so you can fire on your next turn. Two shots left is good for you. And there we go. Oh, and there goes the wall.
The Advent network is almost entirely locked down. We're running out of time.
Oh, Bradford, don't get your panties in a bunch. We're gonna get to it. We're gonna get to it. I preferably want to have Benito doing this, because he's the hacker. So let's put him... That's not really a good position, is it? I'm gonna try and put somebody closer. That's a really weird way of going there. He would go inside and then through the window and back here again. But hey, let's do that! Through the window and through another window. Yeah, let the aliens know. Yeah, fuck. Okay, let the aliens know we're here. That's what I wanted to say. So this is a problem, because we now have no sight of those guys. No sight at all. We could get ourselves a bit closer. I think if I put Benito over there, he should have sight on one of them. Yeah, there we go. So there's the sectoid. I could already hack the thing from here if I wanted to, but I'm not gonna do that just yet. I'm wondering, since this is not cover... Oh no, you can't actually see him. Should be a pretty straight line. I think I'm gonna put Benito on the other side of the door. Out of sight of the aliens, so he shouldn't be in trouble over there. There we go, let's put him over there. Now none of the aliens can see any of my troops, so they should move, hopefully. Because there's one on the side of the building, I don't think he can move to the corner here immediately. So Smongo should be safe, and Torilia can get a shot through the window if the sectoid or the trooper passes. So let's put everybody on overwatch. Yeah, there we go. Is that Smongo? Yeah, okay. 3 damage, which is great. And there we have the sniper shot through the window in the face, please. Oh, I missed. That was too bad. That would have been really nice if he took out the sectoid like that. So now he's probably gonna Oh, panicking. Panicking is bad. Unless he shoots at the sectoid in response. Okay, he moves. and he hunkers down, which is not that bad. Oh, but that's great. Ooh, that's less great. Oh, that was the wall. How can you see him? I mean, there's a complete wall in the way. Okay, Cedric is panicking, so we can't use him. But do we have another grenade? We have. So you guys... Oh, for fuck's sake. Oh, give me sight. I can't see inside of the building. Maybe over here with the grenade? Yeah, okay. So right over here. I shouldn't destroy the terminal this way, because the terminal is in the adjacent tile. And I can't put this any other way to hit both of them. And they do lose their cover. Well, one side of their cover, for the sectoid at least. But that should bring them either... The trooper could be dead, or to the brink of death. But hey, here we go. Yeah, catch. Okay, that was a really, really fast explosion. Holy shit. Okay. So now we have two shots left. Oh god, this is gonna have to work. So we're gonna open the door, because they didn't know we were here. So now we need to hack something that isn't there anymore, by the way. That's gonna be a problem. Can you still... Ooh. I don't know what's gonna happen now, actually. So 78 and 74. 77. Oh, he can't even see the sectoid. What? Well, good luck, I checked. You shoot the trooper. There we go, there goes the trooper, and they dropped something. Two things, apparently. And then we have the sectoid, please. 78%. Oh god, yeah, thank you. But I don't know what's gonna happen now. Because the...
Burning through ammo,
positive confirmation. Area secured.
Okay.
Menace 1-5, the Advent network terminal is shutting down. This is your last chance to secure the data.
That's all very nice, but there's nothing to hack anymore. Dude? We kind of blew up the thing. So I think it's supposed to be over there on this tile. So maybe if I move over here. Oh god. This is a problem. This is a really big problem. Am I gonna fail this mission just because there is no terminal there? Because that's not good. So I can grab the loot. Ooh, three thingies. That's good. Wait. Yes. Benito can still hack it with the drone. Oh god, that was lucky. Yeah, you're just hacking a wall right now, but hey. Let's see, so delays the current dark event projects. We didn't even see a dark event yet. For 56%, or research time on the current tech reduced by 50%. I think we're researching something that's only taking a few days, so I'm gonna go for this one. Oh, and we get it. So we delayed the dark events by 2 weeks. But we don't have dark events yet, so don't know how that will work. So yeah, dark events are bad effects that we can have. But that's the mission, I think.
Status confirmed. Mission accomplished.
Flawless. No soldiers wounded and no soldiers killed. Great. And therefore we get the very, very inspiring music of XCOM 2. Because we had a flawless mission. So a successful shot percentage. Apparently 2 out of 3. Benito did most damage, Smongo did most attacks and was most under fire but never got hit, and Benito also moved the furthest. But of course, what's a lot more important right now is of course the promotions we're gonna get. Because I think both Smongo and Trophinet are gonna get their promotions. There we go, back at the Avenger. I still kind of think it's a bit cheesy to call this thing the Avenger, but hey. I think we have... Oh! Wow!
Hell of a job.
Everybody got a promotion. I totally missed that. So Benito, let's see. Next up, we could either make him a medic or a hacker. A really aggressive combat hacker. Right now, I think we should go for combat hacker to start with. Because, well, the good offense is the best defense, right? Here we go, combat protocol. So combat protocol sends the gremlin to an enemy and we can deal some guaranteed damage, which is handy, certainly at this point, with our bad shot percentages. But that's his promotion. Then we have Smongo. Who is Smongo going to be? Which class is he going to be? Oh, also a specialist. Oh, that's interesting. I thought he was going to get the one we're missing, the ranger. But never mind, I can always use another specialist. We're going to make him the medic then. Then we have Cedric's promotion, which would get him... Long Watch is really, really good. So Long Watch allows Overwatch to trigger on squad sites or even on enemies that are beyond his normal reach, as long as somebody else has a line of sight of him. But return fire is a bit worse. When targeted by enemy, fire automatically fire back with your pistol once per turn. We don't want to get fired upon, so giving us abilities that react to that is maybe not the best way to spend our ability points. So Long Watch it is. There we go. And now we have Trophy Nut, and I think I already see what he's going to be, because it kind of looks like he's holding a shotgun. Oh no! Sharpshooter! Again! In my original playthrough, I was also a sharpshooter, so another sharpshooter then. I really want a ranger. I really, really want another ranger. But there we go, promotions all around. And then we got those loots, so we got a hair trigger for our weapon. A soldier has a 5% chance that the shot they take will not cost an action. Then we have the chip, a chip we can implant in one of our soldiers, granting 13 will, which is not really that great. And then an Advent data pad. These contain vital data about Advent strategy and communication. Our research team can crack them to gain intel, but it will take some time. Okay, and then we have corpses of everything we killed. There we go, decryption.
Now that we've got some help, we can start clearing out the old equipment and debris from the ship to make room for new facilities.
So there we go, we got an engineer. And what can we do with engineers? Well, to start off, all these slots we can actually create rooms in, rooms with varying purposes. We're gonna start by clearing out the debris from... okay,
first,
there we go.
We'll need to assign an engineer to the task. Once we start getting into the far reaches of the ship, it's going to take more time and manpower to make space for new facilities.
Okay, so we need to assign the engineer we just got to here, and she will clear out the debris, and we actually get supplies for that as well. So it doesn't cost anything to drill anymore, as it did in the previous game, but we actually get something in return. So engineer required, let's put Maria Kuznetsova.
Looks good
in
to
there,
me.
Our
just
engineer.
Give the word and we'll get started, Commander.
And we'll give the word. Excavate.
Excavation is underway, Commander, but it's going to take some time to get all that stuff cleared out.
So in 5 days,
Commander,
that slot is going to be open.
Transmission coming through. Source unknown. Patching it through to your quarters.
Thank you, Bradford. So we cleared out that alien debris, and that's going to take 5 days, and then we're going to get 28 extra supplies as well. So let's go to our quarters, because we are receiving a transmission. There we go. Patchy transmission.
Hello, Commander. The Council you once knew is no more. Its membership have all sworn loyalty to the Advent Administration. With one exception. It is good to see you again. In the days since your capture, I have done all I can to aid the Resistance from the inside. It was these Resistance operatives that provided the intel leading to your recent extraction. As of now, Resistance forces are currently somewhat disorganized. If we are to defeat Advent and their alien masters, you must change this before it is too late. What you are seeing are classified reports of missing civilians from across the world. Their numbers are growing. We suspect they have been taken to a nearby Advent Black Site, though its exact location remains unknown. Time is short, Commander. We need you to take charge of resistance operations throughout the world. Establish contact with the local cells and bring them into the fold. Find this black site and shut it down. Save our world. The clock is ticking. Good luck, Commander.
Thank you, Counselor. So that was the guy that actually got us the information that got us out
Looks
of that
like
stasis bolt.
Let's get started, Commander. I'll be on the bridge when you're ready.
Yeah, you will be on the bridge when I'm ready. But I'm not ready yet. So, the Counselor just gave us another mission, but the Counselor also started to indicate a bit of bigger trouble, the Avatar Project. But we don't know much about that yet, because that's what that next mission is all about. What else are we going to do? I'm going to quickly check out our soldiers, which I apparently cannot do. Because, yeah, we're forced to go to the bridge right now. But I'm not going to do that just yet. Then, sadly, I can't do anything else right now. So I'm going to take a little break. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. And if you haven't already, don't forget to give it a thought to subscribe to my channel, because I really appreciate any support you guys can give me. And also, don't forget to add any characters you still want to add, because that's still open for recruitment as well. So thanks again, enormously, for watching, and I hope to see you in the next episode or series. Goodbye.